We are going to discuss the charging and discharging of a capacitor, and we also calculate dielectric constant of various capacitors. Beginning with, we here have taken the capacitor C1. The circuit diagram is as shown in the figure. The circuit connections will be done as per the circuit diagram. Here we have A and X has been connected, and Y to B, and we here using the resistance value as 100 kilo ohms. Also, you could able to see the C as for the charging, D is for the discharging. Here we have the stop clock button. If it is towards halt, the timer will stop. If it is towards start, the timer will run. And the resistance has been connected to the 100 kilo ohms. And one of the capacitors we have used, that is C1, across which the voltage will be measured, and it is connected to the digital voltmeter. Now, if I want to observe the charging of a capacitor, this knob has to be towards C. And this halt button has to be towards start mode. And gradually, for every 15 seconds, we here record the voltage values till the voltage remains constant, stabilized. After that, again, we are going to discharge the capacitor. And for every 15 seconds, the discharging voltage value will be recorded. Now, let us charge the capacitor C1. For that, I need to press this button towards C, and I have to press this halt button towards start. Now, you can observe, for every 15 seconds, we will be recording the value of the voltage. So here it comes, 15, 3.31 volts has been recorded. Accordingly, till the voltage gets stabilized, we will be recording the values for every 15 seconds. You can observe the voltage has gradually increased at the beginning till 45 seconds. Later on, it is increasing only in the second decimal. Almost it has remained constant as 4.51 volts. Now it has 4.51. Now let me discharge the capacitor. Again, press the reset button. Initially, press this one towards halt, press reset, it starts from zero, and soon you press both these buttons, again it starts decreasing from the maximum 4.54 volts. It has to be recorded for the zeroth second while discharging. From that 4.54, the capacitor gradually decreases to zero. For every 15 seconds again, you are about to record the values. Observe carefully. 30th seconds already it has decreased to 0.20. So for the 45 seconds, the value of the voltage across the capacitor C1 has reduced to zero. And thereafter, all the values will be taken as zero for the rest of the 15 seconds. For the different capacitors, the charging and discharging voltage may go into vary. As for the capacitor C1 is concerned, the capacitor C1 has decreased to zero for the 75th second only, but it may vary for the C2 and C3 accordingly. And once, if you have recorded the values of the voltage for every 15 seconds. Afterwards, a graph has to be drawn, taking the voltage along the y-axis and time interval along the x-axis. So for the along the x-axis, take the one division value as 15 seconds, take the voltage value along the x-axis for one division as 1 volt. Then, after marking the points for the charging and discharging points, two curves where they're going to intersect meet, the corresponding time interval value will be taken as Tp. We have the dielectric constant relation as K equals to 1.44 capital Tp into 10 power minus 3 into D divided by epsilon naught A into R. This is a reduced formula, modified one, where Tp being the time interval where the charging and discharging curve meets, the corresponding time interval will be taken as Tp, and all the rest of the values are being constants. After substituting the values for all the parameters in the relation of K, you'd be able to obtain the value of K, dielectric constant, which may not have any units.